Hello, welcome to my channel, CB's Coloring and Craft. Connie here. Today I want to show you something new. I ordered it about 12 weeks ago from AliExpress and I forgot all about it till it came through the door yesterday. So it's glittery watercolor, semi-dry, 24 colors, and it is by Simi Art. That's what it says on the back. And well, here are the colors. Solid watercolor is semi-dry. It offers a smooth consistency as well as an extraordinary brilliance, luminosity and longevity. It is suitable for both professional artists and obsidarians. It offers saturated and colorful colors. You can use a palette to mix these colors as well. The color lumps are easy to be removed and replaced in their cases. Solid watercolor also requires less setups compared to true watercolors. It is more convenient for the users to carry and paint outdoors. Well, that's what it says on the box. And I open the box for you. It's a nice blue box. Come with a plastic sheet to protect your paint, and as you see, I already spritzed some water on it with my spritzer. I like to use my Derwent one. It's easy and small and it does work really good. I have those other cheap water bottle thingies, but I like my Derwent one. So the paint has to loosen up a bit, so that's why I already watered them for you, that it won't take so much time to swatch them. I think maybe I can adjust my color a little. More color, I think I need. And I'm sorry if there's a slight trembling in the light. I've tried a lot of things, but it's not working, so I'm sorry for that. I already swatched them on white paper, and you can see they are really, really beautiful and shiny. I don't know if the camera catch the light, but they are really nice. So 24 colors, and I thought, well, let's swatch them on black paper and compare it to the white. And let's do it on a video. That would be nice. So, I have my brush, I have my paint, I have my card. Let's zoom in one more. I think that will work. Oh, I'm sorry. Wet my brush, I don't want it too wet. Because you have to use these paints a little drier. So. Oh, wait a minute, that's the bottom one. No, I have to turn it, sorry. So let's start with this one. They don't have names, but on the bottom of the pens, I can show you. There is a kind of a coat. So this one is called AB, and I have put that coat on the paper. I can imagine that on the A ones, so AQ, maybe it's a sum of gold, like this one, AU, Gold, ED, I don't know, but EB, Aurora Borealis. And then I'm completely lost. But there is a green one that's called ES. So maybe that's Sage or something. I don't know. I can't figure it out. I tried. So here we go. It is, I find it like a little water, like an antique gold. And you know, I have a lot of glitter paints already, but I saw this on AliExpress, and I liked how it looked because it reminded me of the Kuritake pen paints in the same kind of setup, and I loved those paints, so I put it on my wish list. And then when I looked, well, some time, and certainly they were about half the price, and yeah, then I couldn't resist. I had to order them, and because they took 12 weeks or something to come here, I totally forgot about them. So it was a big surprise when I got a package in the door, and it was Spain. Because I forgot all about it. I was busy with other things. No. And this one is kind of yellowy gold. A little more water, I think. They wet very easily. And it is a big difference if you use them on the black paper or on the white. That's why I want to do both. Water is already gone in the paint with some of them. You want a kind of an inky consistency in the paint. Well, that's what I like. I don't know if that's really what it should be. But on the black paper, this white one is almost looking like a silver. I have to clean my brush in between. We compare them later with the swatches on the white and see where the difference is. Oh my, this pink is really beautiful on the black. I love it. And this one, it is a purple with a blue and a pink in it. So on the white paper it was more pink. In the pen it's more bluish purple. And when you wet it, the pink comes up. It's a really strange color. I'm curious. On the brush it looks blue. Can you see that? So oh yeah, it is blue on the black paper. It is gorgeous. Oh, I love this one on the black. It is not so nice on the white paper, but it is beautiful. You can always put on two coats if you want. That's more like a reddish color. Like a very dark copper. Really, now they are really nice on the black paper. This is like a real coppery color, more orangey. Oh, this is nice consistency. This is what I want. Beautiful and smooth. Oh my, it's gorgeous. For now I skip the black because it will be very dark on my brush, and I skip the dark green as well, so I go to this one. So I have to skip two, and we do the dark ones later. Yeah, this one, oh, it's really nice, love it. I love my glittery paints. Oh, and this turquoisey blue is also really nice. When I have to paint a bigger space, I always have a problem with these paints because you always see my stripes. I think I'm doing something wrong, but I'm not sure what. So I put my paint up. And we go to this one. And that's the pink. More bright pink. It's a shame you don't have black paper in your color books. There is one. Oh my gosh, I forgot her name. Ruby Charm something. She has black coloring books, but they are quite expensive and they are in the US. So a lot of shipping and maybe customs for me. So yeah. But somebody told me you can print on black paper with a laser printer, so I have not tried it, but I'm going to. Oh, this peach color is beautiful on the black paper. Really nice. There, it lay down very smooth, I have to tell you. Well, this one is a little more difficult than the other ones. Do you see what I mean by the stripes? I always have. I have to clean my brush in between because I don't want to contaminate the paint. It would be a shame. And a new set. It is more like a skin tone. I have to admit, I haven't tried my Paul Rubens paints, glittery paints on black paper yet. I have to do that. Let's see how they are. Now there's a soft pink, and a little lilac. Pink. Beautiful color. The lighter colors you see more through. So maybe they need a second coat, but I don't worry about that now. And this is a very nice color. Rich gold. It's more like a bronze maybe than a gold. It's a little different from this one. It is like these two mixed together. A little more. And this is a kind of a taupe color. A little brownish, beige brownish color. It's also very beautiful. I dip my brush before I go in the paint on the paper towel. I don't want too much water on it. Then it's kind of a grey lilac ash, and it looks more silvery on the black paper. But you see the lilac? I hope you can see that. It's really nice. And you get really nice water when you clean your brush. This is also a lilac pink, but a little darker. And maybe you like to make it more like a gel than an ink. Maybe an ink is too thin. You don't want it too thin. Okay, more of a petrol blue. Oh my gosh, they are so nice. I have to swatch my ocean holographic paint on the black one also. I haven't done that. And a light blue. So you have 24 colors, it's nice. You can mix them if you want. The blues are there's not on the black paper, there's no much difference in the blue. There's a bigger difference on the white paper, I think. Maybe when they're dry, they change when they are dry. And there are two gorgeous greens. Really, really beautiful. This black paper is just kind of cardstock. It is not too thick, so it's not watercolor paper. And this is like a goldish green. It's beautiful. I'm so curious how it is on the black paper, because it's beautiful on the white. Oh yeah, it's a greenish gold on the black one. Very different. So now we go to the two dark colors. We have very bad weather here at the moment. It's very dark outside. And it's half past noon, so middle of the day. But it's already dark. This green is also very beautiful. I don't think we will see much of the black. It's not a really black black, it's a kind of a silvery black. We call it anthracite. I don't know if that name is in English. Oh, you do see it. It's more like a very, very dark gray. It's nice. It's called AC, so it could be anthracite. Is it anthracite? I don't know. Look at my water when I rinse it. You see all those things going on in there. I love that. And you see the changing color. It's like a work of art on its own. So, put the water aside before it goes all over my desk. So, it's not dry yet. But you can see that the dry colors, they are really bright. So I put my paint aside. Get my swatches on the white paper. I made a mistake, I had to make it even rose, but yeah, well. This is watercolor paper. It's Winston and Newton watercolor paper. Can I get it together in the camera? You can see that the black is still wet. But there's, look at those greens here, how different they are. And this one is purple, pink with a purple finish, and here it's totally bluish. You don't see, have to look very, very close up to see the pink. And it's totally the other opposite on this side. And this one looks more gray. And this one too, on the black paper. And this is the pink. This one needs another layer, I think, to look really nice. And you can see that the pinkish colors here, the pink is disappearing. It's more like a silver over here, this pink one. And the same with the lilac, it's also more silver here, the BP on the black paper. And the same with the blue ones, they are like a blue silver on here, and here you can see, really see they are blue. There is a hint of blue, but not that much. So, that's my new paint. Here is the box with the paints again, and this is what they are called, and I bought them on AliExpress, and they were on sale, so I think I'm very happy with them. I hope you enjoyed my little video. Thank you for watching, and maybe till next time. Bye.